Hello everyone and welcome back to another episode of the F1 Ultimate Driver Career. Last time we had a very depressing Singapore Grand Prix. Oh, my voice just died. Yeah. Oh, why's my voice dying today? Anyway, so this time we're off to the Japanese Grand Prix. And to be honest, I am not 100% confident in this race. Japan's one of my least favorite tracks.
Okay, this is Q1. The top 15 drivers will make it through to the next qualifying session. The final five will have to make do with places at the back of the grid.
Let's see, I need to...
Alonso is going out.
Yeah, this is not my most confident race. Oh god. It's very bad turn one. Mostly because this is a very technical track. Of course, technical track plus motion controls isn't really gonna go that well. Oh wow, that should kind of work out. That gravel threat.
Alonso goes fastest. Alonso leads.
So we need a really good qualifying here. This is one of these races where qualifying matters.
Superb.
Cross the line for a good thing. Good lap. Let's turn to the garage.
You're in P1.
So it's advanced time.
You're in P4. Heidfeld is going out. You're in P8. You're in P13.
I'm gonna drive out.
You're in P13.
Not cockpit.
P13.
Because I'm not confident that I've got through. Let's just try and get through it.
Button is in P1. You're faster through the split.
Oh god, that's bad. Bad, bad, bad. Come on, Ferrari, stay out of the way. Stay out the way!
Time's up.
Oh, please stay through.
You're in P13. Well done.
Oh, yes.
The back of the grid will be taken up by Nakajima.
That was worrying for a moment there. That was worrying. I thought I was out there for a moment. Sorry about that, I need to check something.
Q2, the second of the two knockout stages. The times are reset.
Let's quickly set a lap. So we have our banker lap. A bad start. Just see our all line off the track. A little bit of ERS, a little bit of curve.
There are 10 minutes left in the session.
This is absolutely just sent off the track. Oh geez, thanks Bell. Thanks. Whichever one of the Red Bulls that was. Well, time to restart lap again. I'm diving out for about 3 or 4 laps. It's still yet a set lap. Trying to stick it through these corners. Oh my god. I can't wait for the option to tell you have to shut up. We go, send it.
That might be enough to get you.
Let's turn to the garage, let's see what.
You're in P7. You're in P10.
Oh, it just came out
too. There's no time left in the session. Only those drivers currently on a flying lap are still able to post a qualification time. 13th position on the grid. You'll be in the thick of it when the lights go.
30, that's not that bad. It could be worse. It could be worse. Let's see, 13 laps. An awkward number to work with. I'll just go with the pit strategy the game suggests. Because why not? Why not?
Suzuka, Japan. This circuit is based on a figure 8 design and has a high number of turns. So try not to get tied up in knots. The frequent corner.
Try to look at that. Here we are. Well, the steward can just rubbing his racing boys, rubbing his racing. Oh, she's going with the one stop. Had my hand at that.
You gained an unfair advantage there. Been given a drive-through penalty.
No. I'm not dealing with a drive-through penalty for going slightly wide. Well, that didn't happen either. Because I'm sorry, I'm not taking that. Oh, jumped! The McLaren there. The start. Come on, can I get past Reagan? Yeah, don't care. I got past Reichner. Right. That's why when they're able to control their speed and I'm forced to use two buttons to try and control speed, they're gonna get it a lot easier than I will. Oh wow, that was a really good attack there. Oh god, the frame rate doesn't like looking up the hill. Also, it sounds really loud with all these crits.
Yeah. Being held up.
I wouldn't say that, yeah. I wouldn't say so, Jeff.
You've got a stop-go penalty. Return to the pit. Return to the pit.
That is a bullshit.
Bullshit.
Oh, I'm sorry, I've just been slingshotted by the game. The one thing I'm going to really enjoy when I get to 2010 is that we won't have any of these really bad drive-through penalties. Well, I assume. I haven't really played 2010 that much. So I'm assuming that they fix all these, you know, intricacies, what we say. Right, I'm gonna have to come in this lap, because if I don't come in this lap, next lap, they're gonna come in, do my pit stop, I'm gonna get disqualified. Okay, so it's about 63-62 miles.
You're going to have to drive hard if you're going to make up this time.
Gonna have to make up the game's time. I don't assume this was like simulating the Yeah, because, you know, the gravel traps skit you over. I wasn't slowed down at all by the gravel trap. Hey look, it's a game simulating real life gravel traps. Oh wow, the grass is really slow. Yeah, mostly because I was, you know, out of control. This game. Honestly, Toro, you can go fire me, I don't care. I'll just join the other team and they'll do a lot better.
Your fuel is low.
Yes, that's why, you know, I'm doing this magical thing called pitting this lap, yeah.
To go.
10 stops takes longer than a stop go, Jesus. Well, let's just even somehow gain back all the time we've lost due to the game being the game. 50 seconds! Where's the retire button? I just want to retire again. This is my other issue with the game, is that if you want to retire, because you know that you're not going to get anywhere better, there's no option to. You have to continue racing. Like, I've got no hope in hell, I've got no confidence, I just want to retire and, call the episode here. But no, I'm forced to continue racing. And then skip across the gravel trap that won't slow me down.
You're gaining on Kubica.
This is why I'm really confident for Abu Dhabi, is because it has no gravel traps, no grass, which are the two main issues, and it has no corners you can cut, or no like medium speed corner. I'm gonna go pit.
We'll put on a fresh set of tires, refuel, and have you back on the track in no time.
You know what, I'm gonna just go to pit every lap, just to have some fun. Ferrari go slow. Come on, gap's there.
Let the driver behind you pass. The stewards have given you a drive-through penalty. You must return to the pits. There's a faster driver behind you. Move over and let him pass.
Yeah, I bet the other team will be like, oh, this driver is absolute garbage, he ain't gonna be able to do anything. Honestly, if I get fired from Toro Rosso, I won't really care. I probably sound like a broken record after saying that so many times. Realistically, I'm just gonna sign for any team, do a lot better, and I'll get back on the goal, which is to go to Red Bull. Yeah, but that's dead, mate. They're dead. Didn't even stop. Wait, what? Jeff, a tire. I need a tire change. There we are. I see if I raise it. Service me.
That collision has inflicted some damage on your rear wing.
Yeah, it's almost like the gravel traps don't work. Oh, we got some side by side action. Come on, get back here. Been out of that.
You've been given a drive-through penalty. Return to the pits. Repeat, return to the pits.
Well, we've been given a drive-through penalty. Jeff just can't shut up, can he?
Stop this lap. Pit stop this lap. Let the driver behind you pass. Our data is showing a technical issue with your car. Pit this lap. Repeat, pit this lap. There's some damage to your right rear tire. There's been an incident up ahead. No overtaking. Repeat, no overtaking. issue with your car. Pit this lap. Repeat, pit this lap.
Oh my god. If you're to cut this episode, literally to every single time Jeff is speaking, it'd probably be quite long. I would guess like over 50% of the total thing.
Your nose cone is damaged. There's a faster driver behind you. Move over and let him pass. Hard data is showing a technical issue with your car. Pit this lap. Repeat, pit this lap. There's a faster driver behind you. Move over and let him pass.
Wait, am I not even getting service? No! What?
Let the driver behind you pass.
What's happening in the game?
The data is showing a technical issue with your car. Pit this lap. Repeat, pit this lap.
Jeff, I just pitted that you guys ignored me. Oh my god, the game is broken. We've broken the game. This game is perfectly made.
There's a faster driver behind you. Move over and let him pass.
Wow, but Hamilton went for the dive up
in. Is showing a technical issue with your car. Pit this lap. Repeat, pit this lap.
Oh my god, I think the Ferrari just lost his front wing. Oh, what the hell?
Our data is showing a technical issue with your car. Pit this lap. Repeat, pit this lap. There's a faster driver behind you. Move over and let him pass.
Where are the yellow flag?
Yellow flag. No overtaking.
A technical issue with your car. Pit the lap. Pit the lap. Okay, so if I was to take the chicane. Hang on, Jeff. I just need to head into the pit. Your car. Pit the lap. Yes! Finally!
You finished 19th. We'll put on a fresh set of tires, refuel, and have you back on the track in no time.
Stopped in the pit stop even though that's the end of the race. Where are we now? We dropped down to 14th. Toro Rosso is still 9th in his constructor standing. What's the team gonna say now? It's gonna be something negative, I can tell you that. Assured to wait passing that the race in San Pablo would not end the same way. If I they're just recycling the same things, just changing up the track location. That's all they're doing then. Yeah, after that interesting Grand Prix, we're going to end the episode here. Thank you for watching, we'll see you guys next episode for the Brazilian Grand Prix.